It's your day as well, and let's give them a round of applause. Finally, I want to thank Dr. Clark and the entire LSU Miss faculty and student body for inviting me here today. LSU Miss had another phenomenal year. It is inspiring to see so many graduates out there. But y'all excel in more than academics. The pilot also dominated in basketball, baseball, and debate this year. We are fortunate to have such a well-rounded school right here in Shreveport. LSUS is an essential part of our community. It is the only public university in Shreveport that offers undergraduate degrees, four-year undergraduate degrees, and graduate programs. LSUS turns local talent into pilots. It turns them into leaders. And that's why we're here today. We're here to celebrate Shreveport's next generation of leaders. It isn't easy to walk across the stage. It takes years of hard work and dedication. Late night study sessions and gallons of coffee, followed by more study. Well, the big day has finally arrived, and some of you have earned degrees in education, finance, and biology, others in nursing, history, and psychology. But what you all share is that you have learned what you are made of. You have learned that you can persevere, that you can overcome challenges, and you can't put a price tag on that. Take Sharita Fields, for example. Sharita is a single mom who lost her mother to breast cancer in 2004. 10 years later, she lost her sister in a tragic accident. And I know that your mom and sister are so proud of you today. Today, Sharita's 12-year-old little boy, Jaden, will watch his mom graduate with a bachelor's degree in business administration. He now knows that he can accomplish anything, so long as he's willing to work for it, because he watched his mom do it. Like Sharita's son, Jaden, I was in middle school when my mother graduated from this exact same institution. And I can tell you this, it meant the world to me. I was so proud of her. She too was a single mother who had worked multiple jobs to make ends meet. And we might have lived in a poor neighborhood, but I didn't come from nothing. I came from a home full of love and support. And my mom has always had this unwavering belief in me, this conviction that I could achieve anything that I put my mind to. I remember when I got my acceptance letter to my dream law school, I was so excited that the first thing that I did was I called my mother. I called her and I said, "Mom, I got in." Her response was, "That's great, I'm proud of you." And I gotta be honest, I thought she'd be a little bit more excited than that. And don't get me wrong, she was very, very proud of me. But she wasn't shocked. She wasn't surprised because she believed in me. She had faith in me, and by her example, she taught me to believe in myself. That's what college gives you. It gives you self-confidence. College teaches you to believe in yourself, and that belief can take you anywhere you want to go. Too often, college graduates are told it's time to get a real job, which is code word for a job you don't love. I'm here to tell you that isn't true. When you have self-confidence, you can accomplish anything. You don't settle for a job you don't love because you know that you can overcome the obstacles between you and the job that you do love. You know that you can take the road less traveled and still succeed because you've already done it. You've sat through Dr. White's history lectures. You've stayed up all night poring over all the names and dates. And the next morning, you rose to the occasion. You walked into her class, passed your exam, and that's where confidence comes from. It comes from achievement. And achievement is never easy. The road less traveled isn't easier, softer. It is the high road. I think that's what accounts for the middle American renaissance that's going on right now. The fastest growing cities aren't the big coastal cities anymore. Our generation is passing up on those fake chicks for quality of life. We are choosing purpose. No matter where we are, we can set our desires aside and connect with another person. Someone in need of help. We can always gift our talents to the people around us, to our communities. That's what makes life rewarding. Serving one another. Serving our hometowns. Service is a higher call, and when we answer that call, we step onto a higher path. You all will answer that call in different ways. Some of you will become doctors and nurses. Others will become teachers and social workers. Shreveport's next class of entrepreneurs will walk across the stage today, alongside future lawyers and politicians. But each of you has a chance to make a difference. Each one of you has the opportunity to do something great and something meaningful. You are the future of Shreveport, you are the future of America, and your passion is the lifeblood of this community. Follow that passion. Don't settle. This city realizes its potential only when you realize your own. When teachers bring their passion to the classroom, our educational system improves, which means the next generation will be even smarter and more ambitious. When doctors and nurses love what they do, when they take the time to connect with their patients, when they volunteer at free clinics, Shreveport is much healthier. When politicians